Hello. This is an unusual film. I suppose it's a kind of time team behind the scenes, if you like. It's a collection of photographs. I was unusual, actually, on time team in habitually taking photographs nearly all the time at many of the shoots on initially 35 millimeter film cameras, and then I gravitated to digital cameras. They've all ended up in albums all over the place. To be perfectly honest, I don't know who some of the people are. I don't know when many of the photographs were taken. I don't even recognize some of the digs, or if I do, I'm not quite sure where they were. Only the other day I heard an interview with Mick Jagger, or read an interview, I should say, in which he said he'd given up on his autobiography. He didn't want to live in the past. And I certainly don't want to either. But you are stuck with memories. And while I make absolutely no apology for the fact that I've just thrown in these photographs pretty much as they came to hand, that's in a way how I remember time team. It's just a jumble of memories. It's not a sequence of places here and then onto the next one and dates or anything like that. It's just a whole collection of scenarios and situations and incidents and you name it, I don't know. But the photographs are all here. I've scanned them in laboriously from the film ones. And I think I've pretty much put them all in. I guess all I can say to you, if you're watching this, if you enjoyed the program, is that you might get some pleasure out of trying to guess where they were taken, who some of the people are. You won't recognize a lot of them because these are the people who were behind the scenes. It's always difficult to remember that the program, the whole purpose of the program, the whole purpose of the shoots was to generate a television film just over 45 minutes long, which would run for an hour with a couple of ad breaks in the middle. And yet there was a vast circus going along behind it. And so if you were involved in it, if you were actually there, your perception and experience of it was entirely different from the finished films. And quite often when I have seen one of the finished films, it doesn't really match my recollection of being there. So these photographs are going to look very different from the television programs. Although you will see elements in them that are recognizable, you may notice some scenes that are clearly being filmed in the background. You are going to recognize some individuals. I hope you enjoy it. It's just an archive, really, just for the hell of it. And I suppose it's better that it sits here on YouTube so that people can see it and get some pleasure out of it, rather than the photographs just quietly festering away in my album. The funny thing is, really, and I've had mentioned this elsewhere, the only relic I really have of all that time is this. And that's a Second World War US Army Air Force watch, which I've been using them ever since we did the bomber shoot in 1998, I think. And that's really the only hangover relic of that whole experience that you would find in my life today. So there you go. And here are the photographs.
We Thank you.